three C's: cooperating to change our community. Now that could be the school community, the local community, our country, or even our world. But if you really want to change things, if you really want to make a difference, you need to know a huge amount about who has power, how decisions are made, and how you can influence them. You need to have the skills to work well with others, to develop a good argument, and to communicate clearly. And you need the belief, you need the confidence that whoever you are, however old you are, you can actually make a difference. And that's what citizenship is all about. And those are the knowledge, skills, and beliefs that you'll develop in this Citizenship GCSE course.
Chief Constables are saying.
Now, if you really want to change things, you need to know about the people who make decisions that affect your lives, and you need to figure out how you can influence them. That means understanding how your local council is run, because they make decisions that affect you and your family every single day. You need to know how the government is run, how these people are chosen to represent you. Do they actually speak for you? And if you're not happy about what they do, what can you do to challenge them? But of course, decisions that affect you are not just made in this country. The world is completely connected now. And so you're going to need to learn about some of the big organizations that make decisions that affect the whole world. The European Union, the Commonwealth, and the United Nations.
10 months, Mr. Speaker, and so out of touch with people up and down this country.
Now let's think through some of the issues that have affected Britain and the world recently. Take the riots this summer. This terrible scene shows a young man being mugged by people who are pretending to help him. Should those involved in the riots be given tougher sentences than normal? Well, you can't answer that question unless you understand how our court system works, and you're going to be learning about that. Take student tuition fees. When you get to university, you're now going to pay much more for your university tuition fees than previous generations. Is that right? And if it's not, what can you do about it? Of course, tuition fees went up because the government doesn't have much money because of our economic recession. To understand that, you have to understand a little bit about how our economy works and how our tax system works. And we're going to be learning about that too. Some of you may know about the phone hacking that the News of the World newspaper has been accused of. They even hacked into the answer phone of Millie Dowler, the young girl who was killed in 2002. What power and influence does the media and newspapers have? And is it right that they have so much power? This is a scene from a special committee that looked into this issue. And as you can see, a member of the public is so angry that they even attacked Mr. Murdoch, who owns the News of the World newspaper. And what about international issues? Many of us are concerned about things that happen not just in this country, but around the rest of the world. At the moment, there's conflict raging in Libya as the rebels try and get rid of Gaddafi. In Somalia, thousands and thousands of people are on the brink of starvation. Do these issues have anything to do with us? What should we do as citizens of the world to try and tackle these issues? We've just passed the 10th anniversary of the attacks in America on September the 11th. After that, there were two huge wars in Afghanistan and Iraq. The war in Afghanistan is still going on. Is it right that our troops are in there? Should we have gone in the first place? And if you didn't agree with the government's decision to send us into these countries, what could you have done to try and stop it? Now, it's all very well knowing about these issues. You could become experts on them. But if you don't have the skills to understand them, to think through them, and to do something about it, that knowledge doesn't have much use. And so on this course, you're going to develop the skills of thinking critically about the big issues that face our community, our country, and the world. You're going to develop your debating and discussion skills. You're going to get better at communicating and presenting. And you're going to do a lot of work in groups, because in the real world, we all work in groups and teams. And so you're going to develop important skills that will make you more powerful as a citizen. And when you do this, you'll begin to learn that whoever you are, wherever you are, whatever age you are, you can actually make a difference. And that's what this citizenship course is all about.